Week 3's video involves looking at costs and profits. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a sales price here, or selling price. It'll also be listed as. So before I put those in, just note there's different formats here. There's this nice tool called the Format Painter. Click, it's the paintbrush. Click on the paintbrush and click on sales price. And you get the same format, even if these cells are a different color. Let's just change the color of them. And also we'll change the background color to something else. Let's say that that was the font format. Then if you use the format painter, you can paint that across all the cells. A nice quick and easy tool to paint formats, whether it be font sizes, fonts, bold, alignment, whatever else. Everything that we've done so far. Right, sales prices are going to be, oh, I forgot to put the sales costs in again. So it's just a reminder of it's £4 times by the 8, and it comes £32. Notice if I change that to 10, it recalculates the price. So let's put it back to 8, and we'll just copy those formulae down, because I know that the cell referencing will change depending on the row. Now the sales price, I'll just fill those in. Now they've been entered. Notice that the sales price is going to be more than the cost price because I want to make a profit on each item in my shop. So I'll just highlight these. Let's just change those. Remember, oh, dollars. It's not dollars. It's actually going to be, let's change it to number, oh, a format. So format, number, let's change the currency to pounds. And there we are. Right. So I want to make a profit. So I'm selling for £4. My sales price is going to be £5. This short's £5. So I'm going to make £3 each item. All right. So I'm going to put in here a profit each. Again, let's copy the format painter across. So I'm going to say equals the sales price minus the cost price. The cost price is what I bought it from a warehouse or something like that. So I make a pound each one. Let's just check. 5 minus 4. Yes, that's going to be the case. So the next one equals the £8 minus £5. It should be £3. And notice again, because I've got the format as pounds, it's going to give me pounds as the option here. So there they're going to be, that's going to be the profit each. And just let me zoom out here a little bit so I've got a bit more of the columns to work with. So that's the profit each. So I'm now going to work out here the total sales. Similar to the total cost. Doesn't matter what columns I work it out in, but the total sales is in essence going to be the price for one, or the sales price for one, times the number of sold. So let's have a look at this. So equals sales price times the number of sold. So that's selling £5 each pair of gloves. I sell 8 of them, 5 times 8, £40. So I sell them for £40. I also notice I've bought them for £32. So I should make £8 profit on those gloves if I sell them all. Let's copy that formula down. So let's go and have a look at some of the others. Trousers, £225. Oh, it looks like I'm making a lot of money on trousers. But of course, I bought them for £180, £12 each, times 15 bought, cost me £180. So I'm selling them for £225. So I want to work out here the total profit. And so if I copy across, total profit is going to be the total sales minus total cost. There's a lot of columns here now, and people start to get confused about where they're going to, which values they're going to use. So that tells me I make £8 profit, because in essence I make a pound each item, and there's 8 of them, so it's a pound each. If I then copy those down, so let's go and have a look at trousers. They're 225. I bought them for 180, so I've made a nice £45 profit here. So then I'm going to work out total profit. All equals sum, so just as we've done previously. Then I'm going to work out the highest equals, remember that from last week's lesson, so that's equals max. Now note, you're only highlighting the items, not the total as well. A lot of mistakes come in where people, let's do it for the lowest here, equals min, and people highlight all of that. All right, these are calculations, these statistic calculations at the end. So it's not those, it's just those ones there. All right, if you make a mistake, remember, just delete what's in there and redo it. So equals min, open brackets, highlight, press enter, and then equals average. Oh, I've spelt it wrong. I've gone through that in a previous video. Open brackets, highlight, close, and it's £33. Now, some people also decide to do equals. Well, let's do equals sum and divide by, well, how many items have we got? We've got 6 items, and it'll give you that way. However, as there's a function there, I quite like using the function. Equals average, and we highlight all of those. Okay, and format accordingly.